Good morning, children. Today we're going to talk about creating your own Pro Tools shortcut. Pro Tools has a lot of built-in shortcuts, an enormous amount actually, and we have a video about that. But there are things that the good people at Avid thought you would not need, but you still do. So here's a way around that. The first thing you need to do is go to your little apple on the upper left corner here, do System Preferences. You have now the System Preference dashboard, hit keyboard shortcut. Here you go. Before we create our own shortcut, why don't we go to Spotlight and remove Show Spotlight Search Field being Command Space, because that's also recording Pro Tools and it's a conflict and it sucks. Now we can go to Application Shortcuts. While you're here, disable the Show Help menu because that conflicts with the Update Automation shortcut in Pro Tools. It's very handy and I'd rather be able to update my automation than show my help menu. The next step is to go back to Pro Tools and pick something that you want to automate. I use the color palette a lot in Pro Tools, but there's no shortcut for it, so I'm going to make one. You have to go into the menu and find it. It's in Window, Color Palette. You have to memorize exactly how it's written. It's exactly how it's written. I see color, palette, takes two T's. I go back to my System Preference, click the little plus here, and then you have to select your application. Oddly enough, because Pro Tools is contained within a folder, it's not in the list. So you have to click Other, and then go into the folder, and then select it. Yes, I have a lot of applications. Pro Tools, Add. So now I'm telling the system, for the application Pro Tools and the menu called Color Palette with two T's, I would like my keyboard shortcut to be, I don't know, something that's not used anywhere else. Like, for example, Control Option Command C, Add. So now every time Pro Tools is forward and you hit Control Option Command C, your palette comes up. Isn't that wonderful? Another function in the same menu that I use all the time is System Usage. I used Control Option Command U for usage. I'm in and out of that window 20 times a session. It's worth a shortcut. In the setup menu, I use hardware and playback engine a lot. The playback engine because of the delay compensation, short or long, and the number of voices and stuff like that. You have to be careful when you set up the playback engine one. It does want to see the three little dots after. They're not just for decoration. The system wants to see the exact name. If you don't enter the three little dots in the playback engine name, Pro Tools will not recognize the shortcut. My shortcut for playback engine is Control Option Command P. I actually use Control Option Command for all my personal shortcuts. That way I know it's always the start of my shortcut. I don't have to think too much because I don't like to think. In the setup menu, I always create a shortcut for the I/O setup. Here, I'm in and out of that window about 1700 million times per session, so it's worth a shortcut. My shortcut is Control Option Command I. Another shortcut I always set up is Save As. It's in the File menu, and it's Save As dot 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 with a capital A. I chose the shortcut Shift Option S because that's what it is in most pieces of software, and I don't want to memorize a different one for Pro Tools. The good thing is that in case you get confused and forget what you just set up, Pro Tools has the good taste of reminding you your choices. For example, here in the Windows setup, my color palette is Control Option Command C. My System Usage, Control Option Command S. In my setup, my I/O is Control Option Command I, and my Save As is Option Shift S. That's it. So there you have it. You know how to play God and create your own shortcuts in Pro Tools on a Mac. It's time for you to go cut something short. Et voilà.